Welcome back to the Geelong Regional Footy Show, joined by Josh Conway, Alex Tagami and Luke McCullough. But let's turn our attention to the Geelong Footy League. And I can't get over the margin between St Mary's and Bell Park. Take us through it.
Yeah, unbelievable on the Saturday. Fortunate thing for Bell Park. They were absolutely annihilated. In the most extraordinary circumstances, where these two sides that were coming in very evenly matched, just met 4 weeks ago, and then just 1 point separated the two teams. They get to Simmons Stadium and all hell broke loose. 87 points was the final margin, and it should have been over 100. A couple of late jump time goals at Bell Park probably saved the margin from hitting three figures. Just extraordinary from St Mary's, a very young, beautiful group, very, very fast, that they enjoyed the wide expanse of Simmons Stadium and Bell Park. They just look slow. I've said it numerous times over this show the last few weeks, they're a very contested side, very big-bodied side, and they just simply couldn't go with St Mary's on Saturday.
Was it also a measure of the fact that momentum is such a huge thing, particularly in finals footy, when you get the upper hand and you're able to go away with it?
Yeah, absolutely, and that's a point that the Bell Park co-coach Luke Rainer brought up post-game. He said his players weren't mentally there after the first quarter, six goals down, and he said his players just weren't in the right mindset or mind frame to go forward, that they just dropped the bundle, and it was obvious to see. I mean, they were just St Mary's were front runners all day in the most positive aspect. Jared Garth at Bell Park kicked over 90 goals this season, held goalless from Riley Hawley into league fullback. Didn't go near it all afternoon. They were missing Jackson Sheringham, former Geelong AFL listed player, and Mitch Cuddihill as well, two key midfielders for them. But even if they were there, I don't think it would have made much difference at all. Whereas because St Mary's just too skillful and too quick on the outside.
Two former Cats that play for St Mary's. One is a former VFL ruckman in Andrew Banjan. How's he going? Because I heard a rumour in the 2014 season when St Mary's made that jump up the ladder, he actually walked out on the club for a few weeks. Here I open the paper and he's in the best every second week.
Yeah, I think that might have been a bit more than just a rumour, Alex. But no, he's going well. Big Banjo, as they call him.
Yep.
He's got a bit more support this year, which he hasn't quite had in previous seasons. They called upon a young guy by the name of Trent McMullen. He's a name to really look out for. He's played some games for the Geelong VFL side as a 23rd man this season.
Yep.
Just a handful of them. He's one of those prototype athletes, as they call him. He's an ex-basketballer, got a real big background in that, and he's just one of the, he was a natural footballer despite starting his football career late. So he's able to come in as that second ruckman and help Big Banjo and out, but Big Banjo's still going very nicely in the ruck for the Saints.
And the other former Cat, of course, I remember Kane Tenace, I think was the only member of Geelong's list in 07 not to get a premiership medal, AFL or VFL. So here I am hoping he gets a GFL premiership medal. What's happened to him?
In doubt. Kane Tenace did his hamstring again over the weekend, just went down to pick up a ball innocuously, and his right hamstring just went on him. It's a big thing. He's done, I think it's his third hamstring niggle, if you want to call it, through the season. And last final series, he had the exact same injury and played the grand final. The exact same thing, situation happened. First final, got injured, missed the preceding 2 weeks, and then the grand final, they pulled him out of the cotton wool, and he just wasn't there physically. You can just tell he wasn't right. And they're going to have to try and do the same thing. He came out today and said he's absolutely no chance to play next week, and his hope is that they can make the grand final and he can hopefully get out there. So it's a worry. He's such a vital key. That St Mary's team is a ball banger of half-back, and they're trying to use him a lot. Especially with no Ben Dobson, who's out for the rest of the season with a knee injury himself. So without those two players, it would be interesting to see how they get that continuity in their footy going out of the back half.
Bell Park gets another opportunity, but can they bounce back from a loss of that magnitude?
Look, it's going to be hard. I liked them a lot to make a grand final before the weekend, but now after losing, it's not just a loss, it's such a big margin, and I think, as you mentioned, Wes, mentally and psychologically, I'm not sure how you can get back from losing a game by 90 points to probably your closest rival, I would say. It's just a huge thing to come back from, and Colac, who they face on the weekend next Sunday, they're going along nicely, so it'll be, I just can't see Bell Park winning here to make a grand final.
Yeah, Colac, of course, winning through by virtue of their success over Leopold, and that was the result that you expected?
Yeah, I said last week that Leopold had too many injuries this season, and they were rushing a few guys back to get game time in them, and in the end it sort of bit them on the bum, I think. Not without their worries though, Colac, absolute star, deputy captain Ryan Monaghan has been reported, being offered one match ban by the AFL Bowen Match Review Panel, just for a little incident with Jesse Lothian. He's an antagonist to go lighting up the skin of the opposition, and sucked Ryan in there, and he got yellow carded. So whether they appeal or not is another thing, that they may appeal the suspension and he may play this week. But he's been offered the one match and he will be a loss. He's their best midfielder, if not their best player. And he was excellent didn't affect him, he was excellent on Sunday. But they certainly will miss him, real contested big ball of a midfielder.
Well, I know, as we've discussed previously, Leopold appeared, for all intents and purposes, to be a V8 running on six cylinders for most of the season.
Yeah, they've just never got any continuity in their footy. I spoke to their outgoing coach, Steve Clark, on Sunday. Leopold's longest serving coach, might I add as well, being a magnificent servant in that footy club. And he said exactly that. They've just had played too many players and hadn't been able to play their best 22 consistently enough, if at all, throughout the season. And in the end, they were playing, four, five, maybe even six players who just simply weren't quite there. Fitness-wise, Marcus Thompson was one of them. Greg Hardy played in the reserves in the hope that he could play a senior game in the following week, but obviously won't get that chance now. And while we're on Leopold, I must mention Jeremy Larkin also retired after the weekend. A magnificent servant of that footy club after moving from Grovedale a few years ago. Premiership fullback and a much loved and respected member of not only Leopold but the football community here in Geelong.
Just on Leopold, and again, I want to wish Otis all the best. Obviously, he's helped us out heaps of times after the game. Absolutely. Over the years. Is it good for the competition that we won't see a back-to-back premier in Leopold? Obviously, we saw South Bowen all those years go 3 in a row, 2 in a row. Is this good for the competition?
Absolutely, it's healthy. I mean, Colac have made the step up. St Mary's have retained their competitiveness. Dole Park have seemingly got better before the weekend. Mm. So yeah, it all bodes well. I think in saying that, Leopold will bounce back. I think they've still got a nice core list. They've kept that strong base. I suspect they'll retain a lot of players. Just whether how far they can go to challenge St Joey's, who played their first final this weekend against St Mary's, which should be a cracker.
And how can followers of the Geelong Footy League follow your broadcast?
Yep, as always, Saturday, both Saturday and Sunday at Simmons Stadium, kicks 89.3 FM for both finals this weekend and throughout the GFL final series.
And the winners will be?
Can't go past Joey's Wes, they still won't lose a game for me, and I like Cole Higgins Bell Park on the Sunday.
Okay, there you have it from Josh Conway. Stick with us on the Geelong Regional Footy Show. There's more on the other side of this break.